Hi, welcome to Genius Lounge. I'm your host, Matt Troutman. Genius Lounge is the place where we take technology and we make it accessible to mere mortals. Today, we're going to talk about how to create group chats within the Signal Messenger app. So go ahead and grab your phones and we're going to get started. First thing we need to do is open up Signal, which is in my dock right down here. And you'll see I don't have any chats started just yet. So I'm going to go up to the little pencil in the upper right-hand corner and tap on him. And from here, I can either create a new chat with an individual, but in this case, of course, we want to create a new group chat. If you haven't had a chance to enter the phone number for someone you've just met, you can do that right here and you can search for them to add them to your chat. Or you can go ahead and select from your contacts that are already on Signal. In my case, I'm the only one, so I'm going to add me right here, and I'm going to tap next in the upper right-hand corner. Next, we get to add the name of our chat. And if you tap the little camera icon, it'll allow you to add a group photo. All right, now we're ready to create the group. So that's how easy it is to create a group chat in Signal. However, there's more to it. If you click the little camera in the upper right-hand corner, it'll start a group call. You can do video group calls in Signal with up to 8 people. Now, the next thing that you'll maybe notice is that there's this invite friends button right here. You can add additional people. And it'll say this will share a link, and you can choose whether or not an admin has to approve new people. So let's go ahead and take a look at those admin privileges. And if you tap on the name of the chat right up here, it'll give you a little bit more info. So from here, I can make that video call. I can also mute this. If this is a particularly chatty group and I'm trying to get some work done, I can choose to mute them. I can search through the chat history if I tap here. Disappearing messages gives you the option to make the messages disappear after a certain interval of time. You can choose anything between 30 seconds and 4 weeks, and you can even generate your own custom time right here. It will delete those messages at the end of that time, and they'll be gone forever for everyone in the group. You can choose the chat color and wallpaper right here. That allows you to stylize it to your taste, doesn't change it for everyone else in the group. And you can also change the sounds and notifications so that when you get a message in this group, it's a little bit more distinguished between other messaging apps or even other Signal groups. Right in here, you can see all of the different members of your group, and you'll notice this one right here, which is me, has an admin label next to it. If you'd like to enable someone to be an admin, just tap on their name, and then all you have to do is say, make admin. You also have other options here to remove them from the group. You can add them to another group, or you can view their contact details. You also have the ability to view their safety number right down here. And their safety number helps you identify that the person that you've been chatting with online is actually the person you're meeting with in real life. All right, so once I make myself an admin, it's going to confirm, and I'm going to say, yes, I do want to make myself an admin. And you'll now notice that admin badge has been added to me as well. From here, what I can do is I can choose to enable that group link again from here. And you'll see that group link shows up right here. I then have the option to share that or reset the link. If it gets shared online and it gets abused, you can reset the link so that it cuts off any potential offenders. You can also make it so that an admin has to approve new members to the group before they can start chatting. And here you can see those requests for people who have wanted to become part of your group. And you'll see that I have no current pending members. And in the invites, I can see all the people that I've invited and all the people that others have invited. And finally, down here in the group permissions, this is kind of important, especially if you plan on having a large group. Adding members, you can say that anyone can add members, or you can restrict that to only admins, and also who can edit the group info, like the group name, the group picture, and the description. So in this case, I'm going to go ahead and leave those settings as they are. There are two last options down here. They're in red because they are kind of important. If you click on leave group and you're the only admin, it's gonna kind of leave the group hanging. If you click the block group, what that will do is that will make sure that if you are added to the group without permission, you're not gonna get messages from that group bugging you all the time. So that's a quick overview of the different settings for groups within Signal. And since you've stuck around in this video so long, I have a bonus for you. If you scan this QR code with your camera on your phone, or click the link in the description, I've got a free sticker pack for you full of pineapples. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Ring that little bell to make sure that you get notifications about every new video that we post. And I hope to see you around the Genius Lounge. Thank you.